God's gifts to every nation. Thanks be to God for the plowing, the sowing, reaping, silent growth while we are sleeping, future needs in earth's safekeeping. Thanks be to God. In the just reward of labor, God's will is done. In the help we give our neighbor, God's will is done. In our worldwide task of caring for the hungry and despairing, in the harvests we are sharing, God's will is done. For the harvests of the Spirit, thanks be to God. For the good we all inherit, thanks be to God. For the wonders that astound us, for the truths that still confound us, most of all, the love has found us. Thanks be to God.
Good morning and welcome to worship here in the Diocese of Fort Worth. Today we celebrate the Feast of St. Francis. Blessed be the one holy and living God. Christ, we come into your presence today to worship in this sanctuary called Earth. A planet filled with your presence, shelter and warmth, flourishing in the land, expanding in the wilderness, flowing in the rivers. God, reveal yourself to us and show us your face in all creation. God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Most high, omnipotent, good Lord, grant your people grace to renounce gladly the vanities of this world, that, following the way of Blessed Francis, we may, for love of you, delight in your whole creation with perfectness of joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah. Woe to him who builds his house by unrighteousness, and his upper rooms by injustice, who makes his neighbors work for nothing and does not give them their wages, who says, I will build myself a spacious house with large upper rooms, and who cuts out windows for it, paneling it with cedar and painting it with vermilion. Are you a king because you compete in cedar? Did not your father eat and drink and do justice and righteousness? Then it was well with him. He judged the cause of the poor and needy. Then it was well. Is not this to know me, says the Lord? The word of God for the people of God. Let us read together Psalm 148, verses 7 to 14 in unison. Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps, fire and hail, snow and frost, stormy wind fulfilling his command, mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds, kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the earth, young men and women alike, old and young together. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His glory is above earth and heaven. He has raised up a horn for his people, praise for all his faithful. Praise the Lord forever.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. May I never boast of anything except the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by which the world has been crucified to me and I to the world. For neither circumcision nor uncircumcision is anything, but a new creation is everything. As for those who will follow this rule, peace be upon them, and mercy, and upon the Israel of God. From now on, let no one make trouble for me, for I carry the marks of Jesus branded on my body. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brothers and sisters. Amen. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, make us servants of your peace. Where there is hate, may we so love. Where there is hurt, may we forgive. Where there is strife, may we make one. Where all is doubt, may we sow faith. Where all is gloom, so hope. Where all is night, may we so light. Where all is tears, may we so joy. Jesus, our Lord, may we not seek to be consoled, but to console. Understanding hearts, but look for hearts to understand. May we not look for love's return, but seek to love unselfishly.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Christ. At that time, Jesus said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We're here today observing the feast of St. Francis, who loved God and all of God's creatures and all of God's creation. Francis was especially fond of birds, as he thought the song of the birds were singing praises to God. Ah, St. Francis, that nature-loving, joyful saint who frolicked through the forest and fields of the Italian countryside, preaching to the birds and bunnies and any creatures that would listen. Stories are told of Francis being in the woods of Mount Sabasio near Assisi and preaching, then discovering that birds had gathered around him, even letting him touch them. That is why statuary of Francis often depicts birds in his arms or on his shoulders. Francis considered all of creation a family, as referenced in his Canticle of the Creatures, Sister Moon and the Stars, Brother Wind, Sister Water, Brother Fire, and Mother Earth. Francis is easy to admire for those of us who are animal lovers and those who love nature. Some say Francis is the most loved of all the saints, but the least emulated. You see, Francis was very strict in his religious devotion and disciplines, going to the extremes in fasting and poverty. As a matter of fact, Francis died at 44 years old because he had been so hard on his body. Francis referred to his body as, well, since it's Sunday morning, I'll adapt it and say, Brother Donkey. Near his death, Francis said of his body that he wished he had been kinder to Brother Donkey. He did not insist that the brothers in his order follow his ascetic practices, and that should be a relief to us because most of us are not keen on skipping a meal or giving away our cherished material possessions and riches. So you see, there is much more to Francis than his love of animals and nature. What Francis taught and encouraged was truly in keeping with what Jesus taught. I want to highlight three of his teachings today, as I think they might offer us guidance and support during this season of upheaval. One, the importance of prayer and solitude. Two, moving toward and through discomfort. And three, living a gospel of love. First, the importance of prayer and solitude. Scripture tells us Jesus went away for time alone to rest and pray. Like Jesus, Francis knew the importance of solitude for a strong relationship with God, for a strong spiritual foundation. Many of us are spending much more time than ever in solitude due to the COVID-19 pandemic, and many of us are not fully enjoying this solitude as it has now become monotonous and isolating. We have cleaned closets, organized drawers, worked a lifetime of jigsaw puzzles. We have binge-watched Hallmark movies, Netflix series, OD'd on news, and missed our sporting events. How much more can we take? Perhaps a simple prayer that Francis taught his brothers can help us. Many of the friars minor, as they were called, wanted to copy Francis and do what he did. But Francis insisted he was doing what Christ gave him to do. And they needed to spend time in prayer, asking God what was theirs to do, saying to them, "I have done what was mine. May Christ teach you what is yours." In your moments of solitude, ask God what is yours to do for the day or even for the moment. Perhaps it is for you to take a nap or take a walk. Maybe it is for you to write a note to a friend, an acquaintance, or even an elected official. Maybe it is for you to practice fasting one meal a week, or practice a new spiritual discipline, or maybe an old one that you've neglected for a while. Maybe color in a coloring book, or simply sit on a bench and study nature. The possibilities are endless of how God might answer the prayer, "What is mine to do today?" Second, moving toward and through discomfort. Jesus taught us to love our neighbors as ourselves and to love our enemies. Francis was terribly uncomfortable with one sort of neighbor, even disgusted by these neighbors, the ones with leprosy. He avoided them, walked great distances around them, even feared them. Francis came to realize his bias and, in his desire to overcome it, embraced and kissed the cheek of a leper. This act transformed Francis and moved him through his discomfort to a place of comfort. Who do you need to hug? We all have biases. It is part of being human. Diversity advocate Verna Myers makes a plea to all people to acknowledge our biases and then move toward the groups that make us uncomfortable. She says we cannot get comfortable until we go through the being uncomfortable. In her TED Talk, she used herself as an example, referring to an incident with a female airline pilot. She was excited to hear the voice of a female captain at takeoff, thinking, "Yes, a woman pilot." Later in flight, when turbulence kicked in and she thought, "Oh no, I hope this woman can drive this plane. I hope she can fly." Verna recognized her flight bias to be for male pilots. I heard an African-American man share a similar story about being on flight with a black pilot and thinking to himself, "Man, I hope this guy can fly," recognizing his bias for white male pilots. Acknowledging discomfort with a female pilot or a black pilot is the first step in addressing bias. Racial biases are playing out in the news on a daily basis. There are black-white biases, black-brown, black-brown-Asian-white biases. We have biases. We need to stop insisting that we don't. For example, in this hot political season, you Democrats are likely biased against Republicans, and you Republicans biased against Democrats. Some men are biased against women in political or religious leadership, and some women are biased against men. Who do you fear, dislike, and avoid? Who do you not know or understand? Francis hugged his greatest bias, a leper, those on the fringes and outcast of society. Francis learned to love the neighbor with whom he was most uncomfortable. Who do you need to learn to love? Who do you need to hug? Well, when we're able to hug again. But don't use that as an excuse. Who do you need to engage and move beyond your biases, to move through your discomfort? Third, St. Francis lived and taught a gospel of love, which is exactly what Jesus instructed. If we are to be good and true Christians, true followers of Christ, we must practice a gospel of love. It is even said that Francis and his brothers tried to outdo one another in acts of love. Now, I'm not encouraging us to begin a competition of who can outdo the other in love. but perhaps we might try outdoing ourselves in love. Love more than you have. Ask God how you might show more love in this world. There are many ways to love more. Perhaps you begin with yourself. How can you love yourself more? Take better care of yourself in the unrest of our country. Jesus said, love your neighbors as yourself. From self-love, we have more love to give others. And in closing, there's a prayer of St. Francis I encourage you to pray in the moments of solitude when you are enjoying the song of birds or the beauty of nature. In moments of discomfort, when a bias is realized, and in moments where love is needed. This prayer is printed in your online worship leaflet for easy referral. It goes like this. Almighty, eternal, just and merciful God, give us scoundrels your grace to do for you what we know you want from us, and always to do that which is pleasing to you. Amen.
Let us join together in the affirmation of faith. We believe that God creates all things, renews all things, and celebrates all things. We believe Earth is a sanctuary, a sacred planet filled with God's presence, a home for us to share with our kin. We believe that God became flesh and blood, became a piece of earth, a human being called Jesus Christ, who lived and breathed and spoke among us, suffered and died on a cross for all human beings, for all creation. We believe that the risen Jesus is the Christ at the core of creation, reconciling all things to God, renewing all creation, and filling the cosmos. We believe the Holy Spirit renews life in creation, groans in empathy with a suffering creation, and waits with us for the rebirth of creation. We believe that with Christ we will rise, and with Christ we will celebrate a new creation.
The prayers of the people. Let us pray for the revealing of the reign of God in the world, now and always. In the beginning, God was. Here and now, God is. In the future, God will be. Create of earth, sea, and sky, kindle the fire of your Spirit within us, that we may be bold to heal and defend the earth around us. And pour your blessing and guidance upon our elected officials and upon the people and organizations working everywhere for the good of the planet. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Breath of life, receive our thanks for the beauty of our local habitat and all its inhabitants, and lend us the wisdom and will to conserve them. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Light and source of life, heal and redeem the wounds of your creation, and visit the places and people who suffer from our indifference, neglect, and greed. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Lover of all you have made, we thank you for the wondrous diversity of your creatures, and we pray for their well-being. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Author of the Book of Nature, receive our gratitude for the places of restoration and healing, and challenge us to sustain the places that feed our lives and spirits. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Wise Creator, whose works are full of mystery, give us wonder and appreciation for your creatures with whom we find ourselves in conflict. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Giver of all good gifts, awaken us daily to our dependence upon your generosity and make us always thankful for the abundance of your blessings. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Joy of human hearts, heal our human communities, especially those where your word is not heard, or where neglect, violence, greed, and warfare increase the suffering and need of people and other creatures. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Comforter of all the earth, sustain the people worshiping together today and all who desire and need your presence and help, especially those we now name. God, giver of life, hear our prayer. Rock and refuge of all your creation, receive into everlasting mercy all those who have died. God, giver of life, hear our prayer.
Great Spirit God, we give you thanks for another day on this earth. We give you thanks for this day to enjoy the compassionate goodness of you, our Creator. We acknowledge with one mind our respect and gratefulness to all the sacred cycle of life. Bind us together in the circle of compassion to embrace all living creatures and one another. Amen. Let us also pray for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy on us, most merciful God. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit that we may live and serve you in newness of life to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Live without fear. Your Creator has made you holy and has always protected you and loves you as a mother. Go in peace to follow the good road, and may God's blessing be with you always.
Amen.
In the name of Christ, go in peace, rejoicing in the good gifts of the Creator. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.